Benjamin. Benjamin was the last born of Jacob's 13 children, 12 sons and 1 daughter, and the second and last son of Rachel in Jewish, Christian and Islamic tradition. He was the progenitor of the Israelite tribe of Benjamin. In the Hebrew Bible, unlike Rachel's first son, Joseph, Benjamin was born in Canaan. In the Samaritan Pentateuch, Benjamin's name appears as Binyaamem. In the Quran, Benjamin is referred to as righteous young child, who remained with Jacob when the older brothers plotted against Joseph. Later rabbinic traditions name him as one of 4 ancient Israelites who died without seeing, the other 3 being Chileab, Jesse, and Amram. According to the Hebrew Bible, Benjamin's name arose when Jacob deliberately changed the name Benoni, the original name of Benjamin, since Benoni was an allusion to Rachel's dying just after she had given birth, as it means son of my pain. Textual scholars regard these 2 names as fragments of naming narratives coming from different sources, one being the Jahwist and the other being the Elohist. Unusually for one of the 12 tribes of Israel, the Bible does not explain the etymology of Benjamin's name. Medieval commentator Rashi gives 2 different explanations, based on Midrashic sources. Son of the South, with South derived from the word for the right-hand side, referring to the birth of Benjamin in Canaan, as compared with the birth of all the other sons of Jacob in Aram. Modern scholars have proposed that son of the South, right, is a reference to the tribe E being subordinate to the more dominant tribe of Ephraim. Alternatively, Rashi suggests it means son of days, meaning a son born in Jacob's old age. The Samaritan Pentateuch consistently spells his name, with a terminal mem, Binyaamem, which could be translated literally as spirit man but is in line with the interpretation that the name was a reference to the advanced age of Jacob when Benjamin was born. According to classical rabbinical sources, Benjamin was only born after Rachel had fasted for a long time, as a religious devotion with the hope of a new child as a reward. By then Jacob had become over 100 years old. Benjamin is treated as a young child in most of the biblical narrative, but at one point is abruptly described as the father of 10 sons. Textual scholars believe that this is the result of the genealogical passage, in which his children are named, being from a much later source than the Jahwist and Elohist narratives, which make up most of the Joseph narrative, and which consistently describe Benjamin as a child. The Torah's Joseph narrative, at a stage when Joseph is unrecognized by his brothers, describes Joseph as testing whether his brothers have reformed by secretly planting a silver cup in Benjamin's bag. Then, publicly searching the bags for it, and after finding it in Benjamin's possession, demanding that Benjamin become a slave as a punishment. The narrative goes on to state that when Judah, on behalf of the other brothers, begged Joseph not to enslave Benjamin and instead enslave him, since enslavement of Benjamin would break Jacob's heart. This caused Joseph to recant and reveal his identity. The Midrashic book of Jasher argues that prior to revealing his identity, Joseph asked Benjamin to find his missing brother, i.e. Joseph, via astrology, using an astrolabe-like tool. It continues by stating that Benjamin divined that the man on the throne was Joseph, so Joseph identified himself to Benjamin, but not the other brothers, and revealed his scheme, as in the Torah, to test how fraternal the other brothers were. Some classical rabbinical sources argue that Joseph identified himself for other reasons. In these sources, Benjamin swore an oath, on the memory of Joseph, that he was innocent of theft, and, when challenged about how believable the oath would be, explained that remembering Joseph was so important to him that he had named his sons in Joseph's honor. These sources go on to state that Benjamin's oath touched Joseph so deeply that Joseph was no longer able to pretend to be a stranger. In the narrative, just prior to this test, when Joseph had first met all of his brothers, but not identified himself to them, he had held a feast for them. The narrative heavily implies that Benjamin was Joseph's favorite brother, since he is overcome with tears when he first meets Benjamin in particular, and he gives Benjamin 5 times as much food as he apportions to the others. According to textual scholars, this is really the Jahwist's account of the reunion after Joseph identifies himself, and the account of the threat to enslave Benjamin is just the Elohist's version of the same event, with the Elohist being more terse about Joseph's emotions towards Benjamin, merely mentioning that Benjamin was given 5 times as many gifts as the others. Biblical scholars believe, due to their geographic overlap and their treatment in older passages, that Ephraim and Manasseh were originally considered one tribe, that of Joseph. According to several biblical scholars, Benjamin was also originally part of this single tribe, but the biblical account of Joseph as his father became lost. The description of Benjamin being born after the arrival in Canaan is thought by some scholars to refer to the tribe of Benjamin coming into existence by branching from the Joseph group after the tribe had settled in Canaan. A number of biblical scholars suspect that the distinction of the Joseph tribes, including Benjamin, is that they were the only Israelites which went to Egypt and returned, while the main Israelite tribe simply emerged as a subculture from the Canaanites and had remained in Canaan throughout. According to this view, the story of Jacob's visit to Laban to obtain a wife originated as a metaphor for this migration, with the property and family which were gained from Laban representing the gains of the Joseph tribes by the time they returned from Egypt. According to textual scholars, the Jahwist version of the Laban narrative only mentions the Joseph tribes, and Rachel, and does not mention the other tribal matriarchs whatsoever. According to, Benjamin had 10 sons, Bela, Becher, Ashbel, Jera, Naaman, A, Rush, Muppim, Huppim, and Dart. The name of his wife/wives are not given. However, the Book of Jubilees calls his wife Iasaka, and the Book of Jasher mentions two wives, Micaiah, the daughter of Aram, and Arabot, the daughter of Shamron. The classical rabbinical tradition adds that each son's name honors Joseph. Though not named in the Quran, Benjamin is referred to as the righteous youngest son of Jacob, in the narrative of Joseph in Islamic tradition. Apart from that, however, Islamic tradition does not provide much detail regarding Benjamin's life, and refers to him as being born from Jacob's wife Rachel. As with Jewish tradition, it also further links a connection between the names of Benjamin's children and Joseph. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.